गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल एट होम. सो इन द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ वीडियो वी हैड ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ कैन वी फाइंड रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शन एंड व्हाट इज़ द डिफरेंस बिटवीन रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शन. सो नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न अबाउट यूनिटरी मेथड. सो व्हाट इज़ द यूनिटरी मेथड? सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. द मेथड ऑफ फाइंडिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ वन यूनिट and then the value of the required number of units is known as unit method. That means one unit and the value of required number of units is known as unitary method. Let's consider the following situation. If the cost of 5 kg apples is rupee 200 and what is the cost of 3 kg apple? How can we find? Firstly, we have to cost of 5 kg apple is rupee 200. What is the cost of 3 kg apples? That means firstly we have to find the value of 1 kg apple, then we have to find the cost of 3 kg apple. That means we have to divide 200 by 5 kg. So next we find the cost of 3 kg. Here we first need to find the cost of 1 kg apple and then case of cost of 3 kg apple. Suppose cost of 5 kg apple is rupee 200 and cost of 1 kg apple, that means we have to divide 5 by 200 which is equal to rupee 40. Therefore the cost of 3 kg apple, firstly we find 1 kg, now we have to find the cost of 3 kg, that means rupee 40 multiply with 3 is equal to rupee 20. This method is called unitary method. That means firstly we have given lots of number, but we have to find the value of small number. Suppose we have given the cost of 15 pen, but we have to find the cost of 5 pens. Firstly, we have to find the cost of 1 pen, then we have to find the cost of 5 pens. That means 15 divided by 1, rupee 15 divided by 5 is equal to 3 rupee, and then we have to find the cost of 5 rupee. That means we have to multiply 5 with the 3. In this way, now moving to next question, if the cost of 6 meter cloth is rupee 528, find the cost of 9 meter cloth. So cost of 6 meter cloth rupee 528 and cost of 1 meter cloth is equal to rupee 528 divided by 6, which is equal to rupee 88. Therefore cost of 9 meter cloth is rupee 88 multiply with 9, so is equal to rupee 792. Moving to first question, the cost of 10 kg rice is rupee 245. Find the cost of 3 kg rice. So how can we find the cost of 3 kg rice? Firstly, we have to find the cost of 1 kg rice. So let's start. Cost of 10 kg rice is equal to rupee 245. And cost of 1 kg rice is equal to rupee 245 divided by 10. That means 245 divided by 10, it is 24.5 rupee. Now we have to find the cost of 3 kg rice. That means 24.5 multiply with 3. Why we write 24.5? Because we have only one decimal place. That's why we have write 24.5. So now multiply 24.5 with 3. That means 5 threes are 15. Take 1 as carry. Write decimal. 4 threes are 12. 12 plus 1. 13. Take one another carry. 3 twos are 6. 6 plus 1. 7. So answer is 73.5 rupee. Firstly, we divide the whole cost by 10 kg, then we have to find the cost of 1 kg multiply with 3 kg. It is 73.5 rupee. Moving to next question, cost of 10 kg rice is rupee 325. So we have two parts. First, what will be the cost of 8 kg of rice? एंड सेकेंड वन इज वट क्वान्टिटी ऑफ राइस कैन बी परचेज्ड विद रुपी 130. सो फर्स्टली कॉस्ट ऑफ 10 केजी राइस इज इक्वल टू रुपी 325 एंड कॉस्ट ऑफ 1 केजी राइस इज इक्वल टू रुपी 325 डिवाइडेड बाई 10. इट इज इक्वल टू रुपी. So what will be the cost of 8 kg rice? That means firstly we find the cost of 1 kg rice is equal to rupee 32.5. So cost of 8 kg rice is equal to rupee 32.5 multiply with 8 is equal to rupee 260. Now what quantity of rice can be purchased with rupee 130? That means we have to divide 130 by rupee 32.5. Why we divide rupee 32.5? Because we have to find the quantity of the rice. That's why we have to divide rupee 130 by rupee 32.5. It is equal to 4 kg. So 130 divided by 32.5, that means 130 divided by 32.5, 130 change it in, sorry, firstly write as it is, remove the decimal, write 1 because we have only one number after decimal place, that means 130 multiply by, now change the division into multiplication and reciprocal this number, 10 by 325. 5 2's are 10. Next, 6 5's are 30 and 5 2's are 10. Again, 65 2's are 130. Multiply, check the number. 5 2's are 10. Take 1 as carry. 6 2's are 12. 12 plus 1, 30. That means 65 2's are 130. So 2 multiply 2 is equal to 4 kg. In this way we can find the quantity of rice. So next one is Devika pays rupee 9000 as rent for 5 months. How much will she have to pay for a whole year if the rent per month remains same? So firstly, rent for 5 months is rupee 9000 and rent for 1 month is equal to rupee 9000 divided by 5 is equal to rupee 1800. Therefore, rent for 1 year, that means rupee 1800 multiply with 12 is equal to rupee 21,600. So firstly we find the rent of 1 month, then we find the rent of 12 months. We have given how much will she pay to for whole year. That means in 1 year, how many months in 1 year? 12. That's why we have to multiply 1800 with 12, because 1 year is equal to 12 months. Moving to next question, Gaurav purchased 10 books for rupee 160 and Karan buys 7 books for rupee 105. Who got the books cheaper? So that means who buy the books in less cost. So cost of 10 books purchased by Gaurav rupee 160 and cost of 1 book purchased by Gaurav, that means rupee 160 divided by 10 is equal to rupee 16. So now next, cost of 7 books purchased by Karan is equal to rupee 105 and cost of 1 book purchased by Karan is equal to rupee 105 divided by 7. That means rupee 15. Why we write rupee 15? Because 15 sevens are 105. So here we write 160 divided by 10. That means cut the 0 with 0 is equal to rupee 16. So who got the books at cheaper? Clearly Karan got the books cheaper. The Karan bought the books cheaper. So moving to next question. Ramesh earns. Ramesh earns rupee 36,800 in 16 months. Look at this. Ramesh earns rupee 36,800 in 16 months. How much does he earn in 5 months? In how many months will he earn rupee 55,200? So firstly, we have to write Ramesh 16 months earning is equal to rupee 36,800, and Ramesh 1 month earning is equal to rupee 36,800 divided by 16. So now divide 16 by 36,800 is equal to rupee 2,300. So Ramesh, now we find the Ramesh 5 months earning. Ramesh 5 month earning. That means we have to multiply 2,300 rupee with 5. 5 multiply 0, 0. 5 multiply 0, 0. 5 threes are 15. Take 1 as a carry. 5 twos are 10. 10 plus 1, 11. So rupee 11,500. So it is our first part of the question. Now moving to second part of the question. So moving to next part, in how many months will he earn rupee 55,200? So firstly, since the number of months is to be found, the number of months to be found, therefore it will come on right hand side. Rupee 36,800 can be earned is equal to 16 months. Now rupee 1 can be earned in, that means 16 divided by 36,800 months. Next one is rupee 55,200 can be earned in, that means 16 divided by 36,800 multiply with 55,200. Cut the two zeros with zero. Now when we solve this sum, answer is 24 months. So solve it. Firstly 368 multiply 552. So cut the it in the table of 2, because in 1's place number is 6 and 1's place number is 8. As we know that if 1's place number is 6 or 8, it is divisible by 2. 8 to the 16, 1, 8, 4. Again we have to cut it with two, a table of 2. 4 to the 8, 9 to the 18, and 2 to the 4. Again it is divisible by 2. 2 to the 4 and 4 to the 8, 6 to the 12. Again it is divisible by 2. 2 to the 4, 2 3 the 6. Now 23. Now we have to cut it by 552. That means we have to divide by 23. So answer is 24 months. When we divide 552 by 23. Let me check. 552 divided by 23. 23 twos are 46. 15 minus 6, because 5 is less than 6, take 1 carry from this. 15 minus 6, it is 9, 92. 23, 3s are, 3 3s are 9, 3, 4 2s are 8, and 23 4s are 4, 3s are 12, 4 2s are 8 plus 9, 94. In this way, we can find the 24 months.